everyone. Today I want to be explaining about a simple problem for calls in advance. A simple problem for calls in advance. Look at the problem first. X Company Limited issued 40,000 equity shares of rupees 10 each. X Company Limited issued, number of shares issued by the X Company Limited, 40,000 equity shares of rupees 10 each, of rupees 10 each. The face value of each equity share, rupees 10. Payable rupees 2 on application, rupees 4 on allotment, and rupees 4 on first and final call. Rupees 4 on first and final call. All the money was duly received. All the money was duly received. What is the meaning of that? All the shares were issued. All the issued shares were subscribed. All the money was duly received. There is no calls in arrears. But this is the main important one. But one shareholder paid the first and final call amount at the time of allotment itself on his 50 shares. Itself on his 50 shares. That means one shareholder has 50 equity shares. One shareholder has 50 equity shares. He paid the first and final call money at the time of allotment money. At the time of allotment money. This is to be treated as calls in advance. Calls in advance. Okay. Prepare necessary ledger accounts and balance sheet. Prepare necessary ledger accounts and balance sheet. So, a simple problem. There is no premium and discount. Okay, look at that. Application money for each share, rupees 2. Allotment money for each share, rupees 4. First and final call money for each share, rupees 4. The total amount received for each share from the subscribers, rupees 10. Face value of each share, rupees 10. That means, shares issued at par. Shares issued at par. Okay. So, these are all the main important points in this problem. Okay. Look at the general entries. General entries in the books of X Limited. X Limited, first general entry, application money received. Look at the board, please. Application amount received, bank account debtor to equity share, application account, bank account debtor to equity share application account being application money, being application money received on number of shares issued, 40,000 equity shares. 40,000 equity shares at the rate of 2 rupees per share. 2 rupees per share. 40,000 into 2. 80,000 rupees application money received. 80,000 and 80,000. Next general entry. Equity share, application account debtor to equity share capital account. Equity share capital account being అప్లికేషన్ మనీ బీయింగ్ అప్లికేషన్ మనీ ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ టు ఈక్విటీ షేర్ క్యాపిటల్ అకౌంట్ 80,000 So, for application money, the two transactions, the two general entries is required. You know very well. First one, bank account it are to equity share application account, 80,000. When application money received on 40,000 equity shares at the rate of 2 rupees per share. Second general entry, when application money transfers to equity share capital account. So, equity share application account it are to equity share capital account. Being application money transfers to equity share capital account 80,000. Okay, next one. When allotment money due on 40,000 equity shares. When allotment money due on 40,000 equity shares. Okay, equity share allotment account data to equity share capital account being allotment money due on 40,000 equity shares at the rate of, look at that one, 4 rupees per share. 4 rupees per share. 40,000 into 4. 1,60,000. Next one. Allotment money received. Look at that one. This is the most important transaction. Bank account debtor to equity share allotment account. Bank account debtor to equity share allotment account. Okay, the number of shares issued 40,000. Allotment money for each share 4 rupees. Rupees 1,60,000 allotment money received. Rupees 1,60,000 allotment money received. And also, rupees one shareholder has 50 shares. He paid first and final call money. First and final call money per each share is equal to 4 rupees. One shareholder has 50 equity shares. For his 50 equity shares, paid first and final call money at the time of allotment. So, the transaction is to be treated as calls in advance. So, to calls in advance account 50 into, what is the first and final call money for each share? 4 rupees. 50 into 4, 200. Okay. So, the total amount received, 1,60,200. Being allotment money received and calls in advance money received for 50 shares at the rate of 4 rupees per share. Look at the transaction. If allotment money due, okay, whenever allotment money due, you know very well. What is the general entry for that? Equity share allotment account, it are to equity share capital account. Being allotment money due of 40,000 equity shares at the rate of 4 rupees per share. 1,60,000, 1,60,000. 40,000 into 4. Next general entry. Whenever allotment money received. Okay. Bank account it are to allotment account. Equity share allotment account. Okay, so bank account data to equity share allotment account. At the time of allotment, one shareholder has 50 equity shares. He paid first and final call money at the time of allotment. So that amount is to be treated as calls in advance. So the general entry for that, bank account data to equity share allotment account for allotment money. 40,000 into 4, 1,60,000. 2. Cost in advance account, 50 into 4, 200. Total, 1,60,200 received at the time of allotment. So, bank account debtor, 1,60,200. 2. Equity share allotment account, 1,60,000. 2. Cost in advance account, 200 being allotment money received. Okay, next one. First and final call amount. The general entries for first and final call account. First one, whenever first and final call amount due on 40,000 equity shares. General entry for that, equity share first and final call account data to equity share capital account. Equity share capital account being first and final call due on 40,000 equity shares at the rate of rupees 4 per share. Rupees 4 per share. So 40,000 into 4, how much? 1,60,000. Next, whenever the allotment money received, what is the general entry for that? Whenever first and final call amount received, what is the general entry for that? Bank account debtor to equity share first and final call account. Final call account. Okay. Total 1,60,000. Minus 200, because minus 200 means here why I am deducted 200 rupees from 1,60,000 means already 200 rupees amount received at the time of allotment. So the first and final call amount rupees 200 on 50 shares received at the time of allotment. So 1,60,000 minus 200, that is equal to 1,59,800 received first and final call amount. Okay, being first and final call amount received. Next general entry. Okay, the calls in advance is there now. That can be adjusted for first and final call. Calls in advance account credited in above transaction. So, it is to be debited. Calls in advance account debitor to equity share first and final call account 200 being calls in advance amount adjusted to first and final call. Okay, first one, whenever first and final call amount due. So general entry, equity share first and final call account it are to equity share capital account. Being first and final call amount due on 40,000 equity shares at the rate of 4 rupees per share. 1,60,000. Okay, next, first and final call amount received. Bank account it are to equity share first and final call account. Okay, the total 1,60,000 rupees amount due minus 200. The 200 rupees first and final call amount received at the time of allotment. So, the 200 rupees deducted from 1,60,000 here. So, the actual amount received 1,59,800. So, the general entry for that, bank account debitor to equity share first and final call account 1,59,800. And next last general entry, calls in advance account debitor to equity share first and final call account 200, being calls in advance amount adjusted to first and final call account. Okay, these are all the general entries whenever the calls in advance amount available in the problem. Let us see ledger posting for these transactions. Okay, let us see the ledger posting for general entries. First general entry, what is the first general entry? Bank account debitor to equity share application account. Bank account debitor to equity share application account 80,000. So buying bank account in equity share application account 80,000. Next general entry, equity share application account debitor to equity share capital account to equity share capital account 80,000 debit equals to credit. Next general entry, what is the next general entry? Allotment money due, equity share allotment account debitor to equity share capital account 1,60,000 to in equity share allotment account to equity share capital account 1,60,000. Next general entry, what is the next general entry? Bank account debitor to equity share allotment account to calls in advance account. Okay, by bank account, by bank account 1,60,000. Total debit equals to credit. Next general entry, when first and final call amount due. Okay, when first and final call amount due, what is the general entry? Equity share first and final call account debitor to equity share capital account. Two, equity share. Capital account 1,60,000. And next general entry. What is the next general entry? Okay. What is the next general entry? Bank account data 2. Equity share first and final call account by bank account 1,59,800. Okay, and last general entry. So, what is the last general entry for that? Calls in advance account, debtor 2, equity share, first and final call account. Calls in advance account, debtor 2, equity share, first and final call account. Buying calls in advance account 200. 1,60,000. Next one, calls in advance account. Okay, fourth general entry is, what is the fourth general entry? Bank account debtor 2, equity share allotment account 2, calls in advance account. So, buy bank account. Bank account, how much? 200. Last general entry. What is the last general entry? Calls in advance account debtor 2, equity share first and final call account. So that's why equity share first and final call account 200. Total 200. Okay. Next one, equity share capital account. Look at that. Equity share application account debtor 2, equity share capital account. Buy equity share application account 80,000. Next, equity share allotment account debtor 2, equity share capital account. Buy equity share allotment account 1,60,000. Next one, equity share first and final call account debtor 2, equity share capital account. Buy equity share first and final call account 1,60,000. Total 4 lakhs. Two balance carried down 4 lakhs. 4 lakhs by balance brought down 4 lakhs. Next one, bank account. Next one, bank account. Okay, first general entry. Bank account debtor 2, equity share application account. Bank account debtor 2, equity share application account. So, 2, equity share application account. How much? 80,000. Next one, bank account debtor 2, equity share allotment account. Equity share allotment account two calls in advance account. So that means the calls in advance amount received at the time of allotment, two calls in advance account. 159,800 calls in advance amount 200. Next one, bank account debtor to equity share first and final call account. To equity share first and final call account. How much? 1 lakh. How much? 1 lakh 59,800. Sorry, this one is 1,60,000. Sorry, 1,60,000. Allotment money. Okay, total is 4 lakhs. Buying balance carried down 4 lakhs. 4 lakhs. Two balance brought down 4 lakhs. Okay, look at the board please. I am telling once again, bank account debtor to equity share application account 80,000. Bank account debtor to equity share allotment account 1,60,000. Bank account debtor to equity share allotment account 1,60,000. Next one. Bank account debtor to calls in advance account 200. Next one. Bank account debtor to equity share first and final call account 1,58,000, 1,59,800. Total 4 lakh. Okay. Next one. Balance sheet of X Limited as on dash. So balance sheet. Equity and liability. These are all the liabilities. These are all the assets. You know very well, the liabilities are categorized 3 parts. One, shareholders funds. Second one is non-current liabilities. Third one is current liabilities. Assets are categorized 2 parts. One is non-current assets. Second one is current assets. Okay. Equity and liability. First one, shareholders funds. In shareholders funds also we categorize two parts. One is share capital, second one is reserves and surplus. So first one is share capital. Share capital. In share capital, authorized capital. There is no information about authorized capital in this problem. So dash. Next one, issued capital. Issued capital. Number of shares issued. Number of shares issued. How many shares are issued? 40,000 shares are issued. So 40,000 into 10, that is equal to 40,000 shares are issued at the rate of 10 rupees per share, 4 lakhs. Number of shares subscribed, 40,000 shares. 40,000 shares into 10, 4 lakhs. Number of shares called up, 40,000 into 10, 4 lakhs. Next one, paid up capital. What is the balance? What is the paid up capital amount? Okay, equity share capital account, 4 lakhs. 4 lakhs. There is no reserves and surplus in this problem, nil. There is no current liabilities, nil. There is no non-current liabilities, nil. The total 4 lakhs. The total amount of equity and liability 4 lakhs. Next one, assets. Assets, non-current assets. There is no information about non-current assets in this problem. Nil. Current assets. Okay, bank account. Bank account. How much? 4 lakhs. So the total of assets is 4 lakhs. Assets equals to liabilities. Okay, assets equals to liabilities.